Good morning, good evening, good afternoon from wherever you are. Let's get right to it. Hey YouTube, and welcome back to MikeyMixTV. My name is of course Mikey, and for today's video, we're going to be reacting to the new album by Harry Styles. The album entitled Harry Styles is a 10-track LP, and it lasts for about 40 minutes, so this will be quite a long video compared to my others, so I'll try and shorten down each track reaction as best as I can. So, without further ado, let's switch to the reaction cam. Okay, so the first track is entitled Meet Me in the Hallway. So let's just get right onto it. Very ambient. Like it. Such a chilled out album already. Like, I hope this vibe continues throughout. Oh, I like this. You see, this isn't my usual style of music, but Harry is killing it. I can imagine this song to do really well at like an indie festival. If Harry ever decides to play an indie festival, it would be the best thing for him. Like, this sort of vibe is just... wow. Love it. Come on, vocals! Really catchy already. This reminds me of like the whole Joanne album already. Bit country, bit funky, really chilled. Really feeling it. I really hope that the next track blends in to this. I love albums that do that. They just sound like a jigsaw puzzle when played together. Tell a real story, so fingers crossed for that. Okay, so the next track is entitled Sign of the Times, and that is the first single, I believe, from the album. Ooh. Oh, I am feeling this album already. Harry, you've got a new fan. Hello, vocals. Wow. It's like a choir, but it's one guy. Hashtag Zane Hill. Speechless. Don't know the words, but you know what? I'm gonna try. Remember everything
Oh, the choir's back. Do not know the words, but I love this track. I feel like I need to put a light on it. This is talent. The music industry has really lacked some good talent lately. Harry Styles has just saved music. I was never a big One Direction fan, but solo, they're all doing amazing. Imagine that live. I'm done. Speechless. No words, no reactions. Just appreciation for this talent. Wow. Okay, so the third track on the album is entitled Carolina. So let's get straight into it. If the first two tracks are anything to go by, I have such high hopes for this track. Bit of a dark pop vibe. I'm getting Streets of New York vibes. Yeah, amazing. Love it. Come on. Wow. Oh, wow. Funky. Serious downtown LA in the 20s. Vibes of, that made no sense whatsoever, but my god, these tracks are killer. Okay, so track number 4 is entitled Two Ghosts. Back to the country vibe of track 1. Not complaining though. This reminds me of Joanne the song. In Joanne there's AO, which is quite fast paced, and it goes straight to Joanne. And that's what this is though, like Carolina and Sign of the Times were really like upbeat and fast. Now he's slowed it down a little bit. But I'm not complaining, this is a good track. He's going on tour, so I can imagine this song to just be him in the middle of the stage, maybe like on a platform, guitar, fans everywhere, just becoming one in this moment. And I think that's beautiful. I hope he does really well on this tour, because this music has so much potential. Like, I hope he takes full advantage of set design, of choreography, of costume. I hope he goes gaga a little. I mean, I'm not going, but like, you know. I hope for the fans' sake that he puts on a show. I don't know the words, oh well. Halfway, we're now halfway through the album, which is a real shame because I'm really enjoying it and don't want it to end yet. And track number 5 is entitled Sweet Creature. Back to a slowed down vibe. Not complaining. There's not much you can do to this track. Gotta listen, really take in. I stand corrected. Oops. I hope this gets the recognition it deserves. So ambient. Majestic. Amazing. Wow. Vocals on point. Okay, so we are now on track number 6 and we've entered the second half of the album. This track is entitled Only Angel and I've seen some reactions on Twitter to this. And by reactions, I mean I've seen like... there's a tweet that said the start of Only Angel versus the rest of the track. So I'm really, really excited for this one. Let's see if we relate to the certain Twitter reactions. So majestic, heavenly. Wow. I'm getting serious Lana Del Rey Born to Die vibes. Can this be a single? So Lana. Lana should do a remix. Only Angel feat Lana Del Rey. That would be amazing. Somebody make that. Do a mashup. Send it to me. Wow. Come on, Harry. So I guess you got a rock vibe to the album now. I love an artist who will experiment with different genres, so well done. This is definitely the dancing in circles of the album. Did he sample something on that? Woohoo! Is that a sample to something? I'm sure I've heard that before. Yeah, Lana shouldn't feature on this. I take that all back. Only Angel. Damn, Harry Styles, damn. That's my favourite of the whole album so far. Let's see if Kiwi can do any better. Harry Styles is the new Elvis. I feel like this track has given me like Grease vibes. Like if there was ever a video for Kiwi, I can imagine it to take place in like a diner. Like a 50s diner, that's a leather. Or maybe like a Riverdale location. Somebody should so make a fan video of Riverdale and use this track. I don't know the words. Come on. Wow. Okay, so track number 8 is entitled Ever Since New York. I am very excited, like I don't want this album to end. See, the album needed this, a nice midpoint. Cause we've got loads of fast songs, loads of slow songs. We needed this little zone. I'm getting more indie festival vibes. You know, Harry Styles has the potential to become quite a big name in the alternative charts. That is a market he probably hasn't considered, you know, trying to dominate, but he could so do it. There's a tiny bit in this, like, imagine the guitars in Sinner's Prayer. I know I've compared this to Joanne a lot, but this album is giving some serious Joanne vibes. That's it. I get on my knees and beg you. That's what it sounds like. There it is again. Sinner's Prayer. Ooh, ending with a little guitar solo. I see, like it. Okay, so we are now on the penultimate track of the album, and it is entitled Woman, and it's actually the longest track on the album with a runtime of 4 minutes 38 seconds. Save the best till last! Okay, the vocals aren't great in this one, but I'm really enjoying the beat. I spoke too soon. I don't like this track. Okay, it's not my style, but... No, I don't like it. Oh, no, 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 no. Ah. I'm glad this was near the end now. If this was near the front of the album, it would have been a complete turn off. No, I don't like this one at all. I want to skip, but I won't because I'm praying it gets better. I mean, I get it. Like, not every track I'm gonna love. But... You know what? I'm not gonna hold it against Harry because... Someone will like it. A lot of people probably do. I just don't. There's now less than a minute of the song left and I'm still not enjoying it. I'm actually quite upset that this was the longest track on the album. Why couldn't you have made... Oh! Okay, I'm wrong. Only Angel is the longest track on the album with 4 minutes 51. So I... No, I'm wrong again! Sign of the Times is the longest track with a runtime of 5 minutes 40. So, yeah. I was wrong. And I apologize. Oh no. Why would you end with that? At last, woman? No. Oh, just let the beat finish. Christ. Ew. Finally, it's track number 10 entitled From the Dining Table. You know what? It's only just started. Give it a minute. Get to the chorus and then I'll give my verdict on this track. Why would you end it on this? Like, this isn't a good track. It's quite boring. It's quite depressing. I feel down listening to it, so why would you do that? I don't even know what to do for this. It's boring. Even I, doing awful dances, can't make this track enjoyable. Like, yeah, he's getting louder now, but that's the best bit of the song. Like, there's less than a minute left, and now... The last two tracks of this album, didn't enjoy. The first 8 were amazing, and, you know, the last two don't ruin the album. Well, actually, yes, they do, they ruin the album for me. If this was an 8-track LP, it would have worked greatly. Okay, so that concludes our reaction to Harry Styles' latest album, Harry Styles. So, final verdict. Loved it. Really, really enjoyed this album. However, I can't give it a 5-star because of the last two tracks. I felt like they really didn't live up to the other 8. So I'm going to give it a 3.5 out of 5 stars. What did you guys think of the album? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to start a conversation with you all because, you know, we're a community here. Let me know what you think. I just want to say a quick thank you to you guys for continuing to watch the videos. We might not get thousands of views, but each day when I check, the views are getting higher and higher, and I'm so grateful for that. Like, you don't understand. I find it so surreal that there are hundreds of thousands of videos posted every minute to YouTube, and by some mad coincidence, you guys have stumbled across mine, clicked on it, and stayed. It's just, yeah, I just want to say thanks, because I really do appreciate it. We might not have the biggest subscriber count, but I'm happy with how the channel's growing. And I love it when you guys comment. Like, I don't get many comments, but when you do, I'm quickly on my phone, you know, responding, because that's just how much I appreciate you. It sounds really cliche and really cheesy, but I honestly mean that from the bottom of my heart. So just want to say once again, thank you for watching. Thank you for liking if you like. Thank you for commenting. But most importantly, thank you for making this worthwhile. I looked at the analytics. There were people from over 57 countries watching my videos. That's insane. Just below the UK, my second biggest demographic is Brazil. It's just, it's surreal. I still can't believe it, that some Brazilian viewers would choose to watch me, a British guy, making videos in his living room. So yeah, I clearly went on a bit, as I always do. But yeah, thanks for continuing to watch and continuing to support the channel. We're a community, and if I could personally thank each and every one of you, I would.
Okay guys, so that concludes today's video. If you enjoyed today's video, remember to leave a like, comment down below what you want to see in a future video, and subscribe if you're new. I will link my social media somewhere in the screen and in the description below. Be sure to check me out. And as I say in all my videos, until next time guys, stay safe, be happy, and keep on jamming. Bye guys.